curve of water and what that looks like, and how to interpret a graph where there is a heating curve involved. So when we heat up water, we can talk about the temperature in degrees Celsius changing over time. And what we would expect to see is that as we heat up water, the temperature would continue to rise and get higher and higher at the same rate. But in fact, what we end up seeing is something a little bit different. So we start out with the temperature rising, and then the temperature hits a plateau, and it rises again, hits another plateau, and then rises once more. So let's talk about what's going on with each of these changes. So this first segment of the graph is where the water is in the solid state. So this would be our ice, and it's continuing to raise its temperature, but it's still staying solid. At this particular plateau, this is the point at which the solid begins to melt, and it hasn't completely melted yet. So there is something that's going on here, and we call this the phase change. And specifically, this first phase change is also called the heat of fusion. And I'll write over here that the heat of fusion is the amount of energy that you need to transform from a solid to a liquid. So the reason why the temperature is not going up at this point, even though we are continuing to heat our water, is that all of the energy, instead of going into raising the temperature, is going into pulling apart the water molecules one from the other and slowly changing it into a liquid. So at this particular point right here, all of the particles in the beaker become liquid. So this phase is the liquid phase, and that's when the temperature begins to rise again. So once the water has all assumed the same phase, the temperature begins to rise. It reaches a final point where the liquid begins to change over into a gas. So there is a second phase change here. Phase change. And this particular phase change, I'm running out of room, so I'm gonna write it over here. This is called the heat of vaporization. So the heat of vaporization is very similar to the heat of fusion. And instead of the energy going into raising the temperature of the water at this point, it's going into breaking the intermolecular forces between the water molecules and then pulling them apart into a gas. So I'm going to say the amount of energy transform from a liquid to a gas. So at this particular point, all of the liquid in the beaker has turned into gas, so this phase is the gas phase. So during these plateaus, you have a mixture of two different phases, both this plateau and this one. In this one, we have a mixture of liquid and gas, and the percentage of liquid goes down as you move across. And then the same thing was happening over here. We have a mixture of solid and liquid during this plateau. So we have mostly solid over here and then mostly liquid over here. So that pretty much describes the changes that are occurring during this heating of water.